Welcome to Keshav. For all you children, this is Keshav Agarwal, the same gentleman who had helped us out with the Sri Sangeet, who conducted it so beautifully. Thank you, Keshav, for coming today. And so we really look forward to hearing about your life story and to be inspired by it. So there's a lot that you've experienced in your journey in life, right? So we want you to tell our children about it. For the children, this is part of the Careers Up Close series that we do. We do get in guests from different careers and interact with children. So today we are really, really delighted to have you with us.
Okay, so a very, very warm welcome, Keshav. Thank you for taking out the time. And I think the children are here, so in front of the children, on behalf of the children, a heartfelt thank you for weaving together the Sri Sangeet that you so beautifully did. And that kind of gave me that idea where I immediately connected. And with all your achievements, it's been you have an interesting story that we would like you to share with our children. And and like I shared with you, I think Radio Jockey RJ for me has some amount of cool quotient that comes with it. So I'm sure our children are going to love it.
All right, fantastic. Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you for the opportunity. I sincerely thank you and Annapurna ma'am for thinking me up for this platform. Great. So I'll share my screen and I'll take you through. Oh yes, I see a few people. Hello ma'am, how are you?
Very well, thank you.
I'm going to take you through both my journeys as a chartered accountant and as a radio head Keshav that I was. And how was it in radio? What were the things that we used to do? And what happened that I got into the radio and what happened that I came back to the scene? And I'm going to share it with you all. But what I sincerely want to tell you right now before I begin is that there are no rights and wrongs. It's only the situations that you are in right now that you would be, you know, feeling challenged by a circumstance or not being able to find an opportunity. How do you find an opportunity? How do you make the most of it? I'm going to tell you it all. Roughly put my last 5 years, it's been 6 years I have qualified CA. And to put my life into pictures, these are the three pictures that you see on your screen right now. One was when I qualified CA in 2014. And immediately, I remember I was 21 when I qualified CA. And my mom and dad were the happiest. I was the Sharmaji ka ladka wala example, which everybody used to quote in next rows. That, you know, look at Keshav. He just nailed his CA in the first attempt. This is how a child should be. He's 21 years of age. He's holding a degree and putting the picture on his Instagram right now. And people are so much happy everywhere. But deep down inside, I wasn't sure that is this it or do I still need to do something else? Immediately after qualifying CA, the next month was campus placement. I got the offer letter from Wipro on the first day of campus itself. So CA is one of the best professions I completely say. And of course, as they say, world's most toughest course also. Because it's not just passing it, but passing it with flying colors so that you make the cut out of it. So in my attempt, there was just 3% result, which means every 100 people who sat for the exam, only 3 could pass. And in the campus placement, there placement percentage was 9%. So every 100 CAs that stood in the campus, only 9 people were selected. And I was amongst them. So I felt absolutely fortunate that I just cracked my CA. I'm holding the offer letter in my hand, which is from Wipro Bangalore for a position of an associate. And what else could I need in my life? But when I came back home after my first day of campus, I thought to myself that let me try and find something in the area that I like, in the CA industry. I enjoy doing taxation. So I decided that Wipro ka offer letter to nahi amuse karne wale. What I'm going to do is I'm going to hunt for a job, which is a taxation job. And as the fortune had it, I did get the offer letter from PricewaterhouseCoopers in just next 3 weeks. So I just cleared CA in the first picture. In the second picture, I got a campus placement for Bangalore, but I wanted to do taxation in Delhi. So I got an offer letter from PricewaterhouseCoopers Corporate Tax Division. Hindi ki kahawat jo hoti hai, charo ungliyan दसों उंगलियां घी में, दैट वाज द पोजीशन दैट टाइम. सो एंड इट वाज जस्ट लाइक एक महीने में सब कुछ हो गया, रिजल्ट भी आ गया और मेरे को मेरी पसंद की जॉब भी मिली. बट ऐसा क्या हुआ कि मैं डिसाइड मैंने ये किया कि आई नीड टू यू नो रीसर्च माय करियर. डिस्पाइट हैविंग ऑल द एफिलिएशंस, डिस्पाइट बीइंग अ सीए हु जस्ट क्लियर्ड इन फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट, आई डिसाइडेड टू लेट गो ऑफ दैट डिग्री. I'll show you another three pictures which changed my whole world. And then this happened. So one fine day, after spending close to 9 months at PricewaterhouseCoopers, which is one of the finest organizations to work with, you manage data, you manage consultancy papers, you are working for best of the clients, Fortune 500 clients are a part of your service, you are reporting directly to them, and it's such a pride and privilege job. But in PwC, because all the clients are global, so we have a calendar off in the month of December. So December mein, har saal, we get a 15 days call off. Now, I was just 22. In fact, I was 21, I'm running 22. And during the month of December, everybody decided to take vacations. And I did not know where to go. So I rang up my friend and asked him, he was a photographer by the way. And I asked him, "Ke, Garvit, what are your plans?" So he says that I'm going to Dubai, do you want to come along? I said, "Mummy, Papa, nahi manenge." So he said, "Figure out for yourself and let me know." So I told them, "Ki Vaishno Devi ja raha hu," and I paid my passport fee and visa fees for Dubai, and I did go to Dubai, and there we decided to do skydiving. Now I was just turning 22, and we were up for an adventure sport which I had not informed my parents at home. Before we were going to the skydiving, there they asked me, "Keshav, the zinda bach kya tu?" I said, "Of course, we are going to come alive. We have paid 33,000 dirhams for this skydive. We have to come alive." I'm sorry, INR 33,000, but in dirhams, it was close to 900 dirhams. So I told him, "Of course, we are going to come alive." He said, "No, I know that you like radio and you always wanted to do it. But just because you have obtained a degree, you have restricted your skill set to CA only. Promise me one thing. After this skydive is over, you're going to come and write a resignation, and then you're gonna hunt your passion, which was radio. You're gonna try and make into the radio industry." I said, "Okay, done. We're going to this skydive. We'll fly up the plane, 15,000 feet in the sky. We'll take a jump, and if we come alive, we're gonna pursue our passions." He was obviously already pursuing his passion of photography in a different tangent, and he asked me to pursue mine. Of course, we came back alive. We had no other choice. That very night, I wrote a resignation to my boss that I would like to serve the notice period and I would like a relief for myself. Now, my boss asked me, "Why do you want to do it yourself? Keshav, you have just started your career. You're flying bright. You have all the time in the world. Invest your 5 years in the CA industry and you would be such a better man." I said, "No. Now that I have been gifted with time, I want to utilize it. I want to try my hand at something which was always close to my heart. I grew up listening to radio. I always wanted to see how does radio feel from inside? What goes inside that box? Who are the people who make that content?" And there I got landed in the radio, working with them. So this third picture is my first day at Radio City New Delhi as a intern. But it wasn't that simple. There were several challenges. There were several insights that I'm going to give you right now. So if I was just looking at this picture, this was from April 2014 when I posted on Facebook that I had started a new job at PwC, and it is April 2015 that I started an internship at Radio City. So when I left the job at PwC, I started writing a lot of letters to the people in radio to give me an opportunity. Now I was a chartered accountant, I still am, and I was earning good money back then in 2015, but I still decided to let go of that monthly paycheck only to pursue something which I had no idea where it would land me. So now, how did radio came to me? You see, these are my childhood pictures. These are pictures for as long as 8 or 10 years, I could say, probably a decade. Since childhood, I was very curious to know that who are the people who do the radio work? How does the radio jockey look like? How do they decide what music we are going to have? How do they decide who are the interviews, celebrities who are going to interview? So I used to always sign up for all the RJ hunts that used to happen. I used to always win contests on radio to invite RJs over my place and, you know, have their set of activities. I was the one who was always up for it. I never shied away from something. You see, if you want something in your life, you gotta run behind it. You gotta run behind it like a dog runs behind a car who doesn't even know what he needs from the car, but he still runs. So I knew whenever I had an opportunity to meet a radio personality or a radio person, I encashed it very well. So as a child, I used to go to various radio stations. This is of course Ranbir Kapoor in the picture. This was his movie release, which was in the year 2010. And that time I was writing my entrance exam in CA. CPT was happening that time. And I still chose to participate in a contest to go and meet him. So look, these are the instances that made me the person that I was. Exposure. Had I never, you know, volunteered for any kind of these activities, any kind of contest, or had I just shied away from it, I would never have experienced the life that I have experienced so far in these years. So now, having a hobby is another thing, but polishing your hobby is another thing. You see, you could be a good chef, or maybe you enjoy cooking, but are you cooking very often, and are you progressing at it, is a very important question. So I decided, as a child, when I really liked radio, I'm going to practice the art of speaking a lot. So I was the guy who was always asked to host the shows, whenever it was any lady segment, whenever it was a wedding show, whenever it was a friend's birthday, whatever the occasion may be. They knew that Keshav will do it. And I never shied away from it. I always volunteered for it. You know, during this time, I developed the art of speaking. I developed the art of writing content. मुझे समझ में आने लगा था कि किस तरह की ऑडियंस को किस तरह की चीजें पसंद आएंगी. But was I not participating in my academics back then? They were well in place. But these were the occasions that I never left. I always volunteered. I always signed up myself that, okay, I'll do it. Let me try and do it because मेरे aspirations थे कि रेडियो इंडस्ट्री में काम करूं. और रेडियो इंडस्ट्री में काम करने के लिए स्किल सेट क्या चाहिए वो मुझे नहीं पता. लेकिन मेरा जो स्किल सेट मैं डेवलप कर सकता हूँ वो मैं करूंगा. अब वो रेडियो इंडस्ट्री के काम आया नहीं, दैट इज अ सेपरेट थिंग. सो विद दिस बिलीव आई ऑलवेज यूज्ड टू गो टू यू नो आई नेवर हैड द फियर ऑफ पब्लिक स्पीकिंग प्रोबेबली बिकॉज आई ऑलवेज वॉलंटियर्ड फॉर इट. सो यू नो देयर कैन बी टू काइंड ऑफ पीपल. वन आर द वंस हु हैव द फियर ऑफ स्टेज एंड सेकंड आर द वंस जो स्टेज पे चढ़ जाते हैं तो उतरते नहीं है. आई एम वन ऑफ दोस. उन्हें बताना पड़ता है सर टाइम अप हो गया प्लीज आ जाओ. So it's your choice, and it's not just about stage. It's also about how you put forward an idea to your parents. It's also about how you put forward an idea in your client meeting. It's also about how you appear for a job interview. It's also about how you, you know, if you're deciding to join your dad's business, how are you going to interact with the customers? So this art, which is also known as gift of gab, it's useful in a very, very long run, and it cannot be, you know, circumcised into one area only. It is useful everywhere. And I used to make sure that as a child also, I used to go to school to conduct these workshops. There was a magazine which I tied up with who took me to different schools. This is St. Anthony Agra. And I must be what? This would be me at the age of 19 years. And I would interact with school children. I would interact with kids. And now, this is a very funny picture. I definitely decided to choose it. This was Kela Awards. We did it in PricewaterhouseCoopers, and we did it as if we are hosting the Oscars. Now, even while I was at PwC, in the capacity of CA, I never left the liking, the passion that I had for speaking. I made sure that I was always keeping my wheels greased. I was always practicing what I enjoyed the most. And it was because of these situations and circumstances that I was mentally very prepared and confident to approach a radio station for a job or for a potential opening. So we decided we are going to keep the tops very formal with the coats and ties, and the bottoms are going to be absolutely funky. So we chose orange shorts for it, and these were Kela Awards. So you know, excuse me, then we used to conceptualize that Kela Awards kaise ho sakte hain, what can be the categories, and this was making me kind of socially validated. Also, it helped me accomplish my skill set even more better. So now, how I started my career in the radio. I used to write letters to every RJ I knew. I used to tell them that this is the kind of content that you do. मैं RJs को सुना करता था और उनके हिसाब से उनको चिट्ठियां लिखा करता था कि आपका कंटेंट का फ्लेवर ये है, आपकी क्लॉक पूरे शो की इस तरह चलती है, आप इस तरह के सेगमेंट्स करते हो, आपका इतने बजे के बाद सॉन्ग ब्रेक आता है, इतने बजे के बाद कंटेंट आता है, बिकॉज़ मैंने रेडियो को उस तरह से एनालाइज किया. सो यू नो व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड राइटिंग लेटर्स आई यूज्ड टू पोस्ट देम, पोस्टल स्टैम्प लगा करके मैं उसको पोस्ट करता था, कुरियर करता था, कहीं से कोई रिस्पॉन्स नहीं आया. But then I got to know that Radio City has got a school of its own. You know, you must have heard that line that where there is a will, there's a way. And for me, it was that time when I realized that Radio City ka apna ek school hai, which gives you an opportunity to enter a radio as a radio professor. So there you go and you pay a certain fees and then you, you know, they train you for 6 months. It's a 3 months of theory classes and 3 months of internship. But on day one, I had told my mentor that, sir, look, I am a CA already. I'm not doing it for the money. I'm doing it for my passion. I'm doing it for my to validate myself that how far can I go. And abhi tak jitna mere paas available resource tha, maine usse kiya. But now I want to come on the floor with you and do things. So please give me an opportunity of internship with you immediately. And I did not want it to wait for 3 months. And they agreed to it. So this is my picture from the studio on first day at Radio City Delhi. This is the whole radio console and all the buttons right there. And this is very happy me sitting right next to it. It was a very, very happy day. You know, a lot of people might not support you in the start when you decide to do a career. But you should know that is this feasible or not? The only person who needs to believe in your idea is you. But having said that, you should have done proper analysis of where this career or your passion is going to take you. We are going to talk about how to choose, how to decide actually that is this passion convertible into a career or not. I have a very simple 3-step process for it. I'm going to share that with you. Now, the God has been kind, and even in Radio City School of Broadcasting, I was a gold medalist in the 3 months of theory examination along with the internship. I was awarded this gold medal for being exceptionally bright, and I was given Radio City Jaipur to handle there as a station producer. So I used to decide the content for the various shows that go on air during the day. It was a very exciting time. I had never seen such a life. You know, you need not wear chappals to the office. Maybe you could just walk in your shorts. You could wear any kinds of clothes. It just did not look like an office at all. And then began the most fun part, which was celebrity interviews, developing content. So, koi bhi movie agar release hoti hai, so there are these radio tie-ups that happen. And they send a person from radio station to interview these people. So, this was Siddharth and Katrina when they came to Jaipur for movie of their for one of their movies that was releasing during that time. And you see in the picture how everybody is gathered on the street, and this is me sitting right inside their car taking their interview. So now if you ask me that did radio give me more money, so my answer would be I did not choose radio for money. The reason I chose radio was for exposure. The reason I chose radio was for moments like these, which would make me a little more happier, which would make me socially validated. So the moment I used to interview them, and you know, it's a real lifetime opportunity. I have more pictures of meeting other people. This is one of my other friends, Aaron. He is also a radio professional now. So, you know, I have all these pictures where we would just meet with the stars and, you know, we would take their autographs and we would have a very candid conversation with them. My CA profession would never let me do that. My radio profession always allowed me to do that. So it made me more creative. You know, I started receiving a lot of phone calls from my other CA friends. Yaar, hamari bhi radio mein job karwa de. So my only question to them was that, you know, all of these pictures are great. You know, you're standing next to Randeep Hooda and, you know, you're having the time of your life and you're interviewing them for 1 hour in their own room. But my question is that are you made for that skill set? You know, right now we go to somebody's Instagram and we get influenced so easily that, oh, they have such a nice life, they travel so much. Oh, they have such a nice life, they have such a nice home, they have such a nice car. But point is, have we seen what has been their effort all this while they were struggling to get it, or how real their success is? So I think for me personally, I was able to, you know, get to a point where I was kind of interviewing people, I was developing content, I was creating shows. I was able to do that because I always had the curiosity and I had put in a number of hard work. The earlier pictures that I showed you, where I would always sign up for, you know, any kind of shows that would happen. Lady Sangeet se leke towards hosting these people. You know, it was a long journey and I felt very validated. And that sense of satisfaction, I tell you, you can never have a better sense of satisfaction. अगर आपको कोई चीज अगर पसंद है और आप उससे अपना अगर प्रोफेशन बना पाते हैं, you know, which pays you well as well and you enjoy it as well, you will never have to work a day in your life. So all of these pictures happened. There were a lot of political interviews also that you needed to do. So it's not all very starry. There was also a lot of hard work that went into the play. So say for example, if I'm going to interview Kejriwal, I need to know that what the chief minister's background has been. What kind of questions should I be asking? I should be asking questions and framing things that should not offend them. And what is the material? What is my objective of the interview? So all of these things come from the intellect. Now imagine a situation if I would not have cleared my CA, if I would not have, you know, graduated well, I would not have cleared my schooling, or, you know, would not have been serious towards them, how would I be able to frame questions for them? So skill set is not limited to just speaking in radio. It's also about intellect. A major part of you, of how creative you can be, you know. So all of that skill sets come back to you when you have worked on it really well. For people who are in 9th, 10th, 11th and 12th, I would say that, you know, everybody tells you that ye saal main hai, iske baad to aaj hai. Ye saal main hai, iske baad to aaj hai. Aaj har roz hai aur main saare saal hai, is what my finding has been. So you can never say ki ab maine 12th kar liya ya ab meri job lag gayi, now I can just sit back and relax. I am sorry, if you think it like this, you would be very soon obsolete. So agar maine soch liya hota ki main CA kar chuka, ab mujhe aur kuch karne ki zarurat nahi hai, I would never have been able to see this world. Agar is world mein aane ke baad bhi maine soch liya hota ki this is the highest point and I do not need to, you know, put in more effort, maybe aaj jo main kar raha hu wo wealthy nahi kar raha, या मैं अपने उस इनकम लेवल को नहीं एक्सपैंड कर पा रहा, या मैं अपनी मेंटल कैपेबिलिटीज को एक्सपैंड नहीं कर पा रहा. सो वी नीड टू बी कॉन्स्टेंटली थ्राइविंग टुवर्ड्स समथिंग दैट इज नेक्स्ट. आई एम नॉट आस्किंग यू टू कंपेयर योरसेल्फ विद द अदर पर्सन, आई एम आस्किंग यू टू कंपेयर योरसेल्फ विद यू. इफ यू वर ऑन लेवल 9 राइट नाउ, हाउ कुड यू रीच टू लेवल 10? एंड दिस लेवल डजंट एंड. नाउ लेट्स टॉक हाउ शुड वी, आई रियली वांट यू टू टेक नोट्स ऑफ दिस वन स्लाइड. It's a technique that I have evolved, which will help you ascertain how to decide that is your passion convertible into a career option or not. So say for example, मुझे अपनी दादी से कहानियाँ सुनना बहुत अच्छा. This is my passion. I'm giving a very vague example, intentionally. Can I convert this listening hobby into a profession? Maybe not. But if I work around this hobby, can I then make it into a profession? I think yes. So step one of everything that you need to do, if you're thinking right now, it's too early to think. And there is never a good time to think. I must tell you that. KFC was founded at the age of 40. Steve Jobs died at the age of 65. So age is never a concern. But being conscious and alert is important at the same time. So first thing first, you have to find out what makes you happy. Oh, is it quality cheese that you have to do? आपको पता ही नहीं चलता कि घड़ी में कितना टाइम है. यू कुड डू इट डे इन एंड डे आउट. फाइंड आउट व्हाट मेक्स यू हैप्पी. इज दैट इट? नो. देन यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट दैट इज इट अ प्रोफेशन ऑलरेडी. से फॉर एग्जांपल, आई लाइक टू पेंट, आई लाइक टू डूडल. इज डूडल आर्टिस्ट अ प्रोफेशन ऑलरेडी? द आंसर इज यस. इफ नॉट, देन विल समवन पे यू फॉर इट? से फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ इन स्टेप 1 आई डिसाइड what makes me happy is listening to dadi maa ki stories, but abhi ye koi profession hai kya kisi ki stories sunna? Abhi nahi hai. But kya isko profession banaya ja sakta hai? Kya koi mujhe iske liye paise dega ki meri kahaniyan sun lo? Maybe de sakta hai. There are a lot of storytellers, there are a lot of people who make content, but they have nobody to validate it from. They have nobody to discuss it with them and to make it better. So maybe my listening hobby can help me be a podcast reviewer. I could be reviewing a podcast. So if somebody who has just made a new podcast, I could charge them for listening to their podcast and giving them feedback. So this is how you need to understand that what makes you happy and can it be converted into a profession? If not, is it a profession already? If not, can it be converted to a profession? Point number three, what are the qualifications you need for it? Now for radio, I did not needed a qualification. For a lot of courses, you might need a qualification. Say for example, I enjoy cooking. हमारे घर में ऐसा बहुत बार हुआ होगा कि you know our sisters, our mothers, they are often told that कि मम्मी आप ढाबा क्यों नहीं शुरू करते? But as a matter of fact, can they actually do it? Maybe they would have to know what are the hygienes for a restaurant or a cafe. What are the certifications required? For like a license. What is the government approvals that are needed? What is the qualification to be called a baker? Maybe you need to do certain courses to be a good baker. Or maybe, you know, whatever your passion is, you need to know what are your qualifications that you need for it. Or let's say skill set. या तो मुझे ये पता चलता है कि उसके लिए qualification क्या चाहिए, या मुझे ये पता चलता है कि इसके लिए skill set क्या चाहिए, ताकि मैं उसके लिए step number 4 में I start acquiring that skill set or qualification. If I can sail through these 4 points, then I can say, yes, my passion can be converted into a profession. Now, towards the end, as we are nearing the end, I want to hear from at least 5 people that what their passion is. Also, I'll be happy to know if somebody has joined who wants to be a radio jockey or a video jockey or a desk jockey or any other person from the entertainment industry that we can take. Great. So, in fact, now is the time. Great. Let's do a quick practice session. I will just discontinue sharing my PPT for a while so that I can come back to you. Okay.
Thank you so much, Keshav. Thank you so much. It was really, there was a revelation as we went through your life's journey. And really, when a job looks glamorous, it's not all glam. There's a lot of hard work that goes into it. I'm so glad you brought this up. There's actually a child, Ananya, a student, has actually you know, she was about to introduce you, but there was a glitch that happened in the beginning. So I'd like to call on Ananya right now to talk a little about you. Ananya?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Thank you. Please start.
Good morning. Namaste. Mr. Keshav Agarwal, who has been a radio jockey at Red FM, is, believe it or not, a qualified chartered accountant who quit his job to chase his dream. He cleared his CA in the first attempt at the age of 21 and was working at an accounting firm when he realized that he had to follow his heart and live his dream of working at a radio station. Presently, he has his own chartered accounting practice in Delhi and specializes in taxation because tax, as he says, is his second love after radio. Thank you, sir, for coming.
Thank you very much, Ananya. That was such a sweet introduction. Ananya, can I ask you, what's your passion? Do you know it as yet? It's okay to not know, honestly.
I have a passion for social media, and I mean, it's not a stream that I know I want to go in. I am more inclined towards more commerce subjects. But I definitely know that it's my passion. I want to go into vlogging and stuff.
Right. So I insist you should start writing and making your writing more better and better every day. Because if you want to be aspire for becoming a blogger, your content should be the king.
Thank you. Taru, are you ready with the question?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Namaste, sir. Namaste. So my question is that, like, as Ananya told us that you were first a qualified chartered accountant. So when did you realize that your passion was to become a radio jockey?
So see, honestly, in all honesty, as a child, you never know what is good for you. So I never wanted to be an accountant. For me, accountant was always only about Excel sheets and numbers, which was not actually the case. A chartered accountant does a lot more. So the moment I realized I need to do this was since forever. वो हमेशा से ही था that I need to pursue radio, no matter comfort me. But it was just that के radio could have been picked up at any point in time, but chartered accountancy couldn't have been picked up at. Say for example, अगर मैं आज की date में, when I'm let's say 29 years of age, if I want to do radio today again, I can do that. But if I want to do chartered accountancy now, it might be a difficult ball game altogether, because I might not be able to, you know, have such a nice concentration as I had back then in your age. So I always wanted to pursue radio, but the moment hit me that now is the time when I had given that CA degree good 1 year of time. So, you know, I did not jump the gun just straight away. I put in sufficient number of years in it, sufficient number of months and hours into that job. And then when I decided that, okay, I have a secured CA degree, which I can encash anytime. I've got my knowledge from CA profession. Now is the time when I need to learn a new, you know, vertical and explore it. So that was the time when this happened. And sir, what is your profession? Passion.
So I like to dance.
Oh wow, fantastic! And what do you wanna do when you grow up? It's okay to not know the answer though.
My plans like keep changing, but yeah, for now I have to become a psychologist.
That is great. Keep that open mindedness alive. Okay, it's really important. Don't be somebody who, you know, just decides, and even if you want to do something else, you decide not to do it. So all the best with it.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Taru. Thank you, Keshav.
You know, end it with a very important note. You know, you should remember to have a few hobbies that you can always, you know, cultivate. Please do have a hobby, no matter if you don't have a passion, but find something which you just kind of forget to look at the clock when you pursue it. And has everybody seen this movie? Can you recall this movie, what this is? This movie is Pursuit of Happiness. If you haven't seen it as yet, I insist you do it. And I want you to remember one last thing. Don't ever let somebody tell you you can't do something. Not even me. Alright? You got a dream, you got to protect it. People can't do something themselves. They want to tell you, you can't do it. If you want something, go get it, period.
Thank you so much, Keshav. That's been so inspiring.
And Thank you.
What a beautiful way to end it. You know, pursuit of happiness.
Right.
Nothing less, right? Surely we must pursue our dreams. And if our career or our profession is our passion, then what more could we ask for? Sonali ma'am?
Yes, thank you so much, Keshav. I think a lot of things that echo with what I feel about how you should go ahead in life. And a lot of children will now start relating to a lot of things that I keep telling them, while they must be thinking, how can I, as a principal of a school, be sharing such things with them? You know, I always tell them, especially the children in grade 12, enjoy every moment to the fullest. The school days are the best days. It's too late by the time you realize those best days are gone. And, you know, we as teachers, I think, are very, very fortunate that we are still a part of the school. So follow your passion. But like Keshav said, nothing is easy. So hard work, you cannot compromise on. You have to continue working very, very hard and grab all opportunities. That's one thing that I always tell the children. They always say, ma'am, but exams, but cricket, but why this, but why that, and studies. So I think you have to just grab opportunities. And for me, I think the mantra for me is never this or that. I always tell myself, I want this and that. Okay, so get greedy. Grab all the opportunities that come your way, and it's okay to make mistakes. I just saw how Keshav spoke to you about when there is an error. Thank you for asking that question. What a brilliant question. But till we don't try, we will not make mistakes, right? So you have to try to make mistakes, but also at the same time, be okay with that. It's okay to make mistakes and take it on from there. I love the way Keshav dealt with the video. The audio wasn't there. He just took on. So nothing stops and the show continues, right? Just like we are having our online classes. I think physically we are missing the school. Yes, definitely. But everything is happening. We've just finished an inter-house quiz. We've just done an online session with Keshav. He's just helped us do this phenomenal Sri Sangeet that went down so, so well. And while it's all been success throughout, we could have goofed up. There was always that chance. So it's okay. Technical glitches will happen, but we continue. We do not stop trying. And Keshav, while I would not recommend skydiving to anybody, I think I will definitely not come out of it alive. But I think that's a good way to look at that, look at the situation. And children, you can always tell yourself, if this was the last moment of your life, what is the decision going to be? So live every moment to the fullest. Live every moment like you have no regrets. And you will have no regrets when you've given it your all to everything that came your way. Don't regret, I should have participated in the school cricket match. Why did I, I should have studied some more. You should not look back. It's okay. If you put your 200%, your results don't matter. You could win the race. You could lose the race. You could do very well. You could have goofed up. It doesn't matter.
Just sign up for it, no matter what it is. Very true, ma'am. Just sign up for whatever you have in front of you. And you see, and you will just get better with time.
Correct. I just so totally love that one Bollywood line, which I think all children and all teachers would have heard. Judge heal apni zindagi, children. That's how you should live every moment. School hai to school enjoy karo, chemistry hai to chemistry enjoy karo, talk hai to talk enjoy karo. Jo acha lage wo karo. Soch ke karo ki galat to nahi kar rahe. It should not harm anybody. It should not harm you. Keep that in mind. And I think you all are very smart enough.
Okay. Yeah, ma'am.
Annapurna ma'am, can I add one more thing?
Yes.
You know, so over all these years of meeting children and seeing them do so well in life, you know, sometimes children, you have a passion, you start out with a goal, you think you want to do something, but somewhere down the line, you might decide this is not for you. It's okay to quit at that point of time. But like Keshav said, you have to have your plan in place, right? And if your parents are getting upset, it's always good to sit and reason out with them, hear their point of view, you know, because they come with more experience. And always remember, they will never want you to get hurt. So hear them out. What are their reasons? Try and convince them. So it's okay. It's okay to try and then give up rather than not try and regret later.
Very true. Very true. You know, there was a famous line in one of the advertisements that I really remember in my life. He says, kabhi man mein agar shanka ho kisi kaam ko karne ya na karne ki, to us kaam ko kar lena. Kuch na bhi mila, to tajurba milega. और तजुर्बा बड़े काम की
है। वेरी वेल सेड, वेरी वेल सेड।
तो इट्स सेड विद मी।
एक्सीलेंट।
तो थैंक यू केशव, बिकॉज़ व्हाइल वी वर वेटिंग फॉर केशव टू जॉइन अस वन स्कूल रीओपन्स, बट वी जस्ट गॉट अ लिटिल ग्रीडी बिकॉज़ आई थॉट आई डोंट नो व्हेन द स्कूल इज गोइंग टू रीओपन एंड आई मस्ट शेयर विद यू चिल्ड्रन दैट व्हेन आई स्पोक विद केशव ही सेड बट मैम व्हेन इज स्कूल रीओपनिंग आई सेड इट्स नॉट वी आर ऑलरेडी वर्किंग जॉइन अस वर्चुअली बट केशव A request to you, once we reopen, you must come and visit our school,
Pleasure.
Meet with our children. I'm yes. sure we'll have another good session. Yes, children, are you looking forward to that?
Yes,
so they are all on mute. I'm sure you all are. And I'm sure we have not even realized how time has passed. We're already we've overshot the session.
We have.
Yes, we have. Thank you, Keshav, once again. On behalf of the entire Shriram School teachers, children, and Utra ma'am, I was wanting her to join. I think there is some technical problem. She also wanted to meet with you, but probably ma'am next time when you are in school. She's there, ma'am. Are you here, Utra ma'am?
Yeah. I did see her on the participation list.
I think she has exited. I tried calling her again.
Okay. No
so, on behalf of Utra ma'am, too, a huge thank you to you, Keshav.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you.
And we will share your contact with the children because after your talk, I'm sure maybe some of them who were not thinking of considering this as a career option, or maybe some of them who were considering CA as a career option, might get in touch with you. And to crack CA in the very first attempt, commendable. I think PwC and all the corporate houses that you named, I think, are the dream destination. So to take a decision to quit that, but then again, you are pursuing that as well. So like I said, it's never this or that. It's always this and that. And when you think of it and you make up your mind for it, I think you can do it.
Right.
Annapurna ma'am, over to you.
No, so that, no, that's exactly what, ma'am, you said it all. To have a hobby, to have a passion, it actually nourishes us from within while we follow a career. So that keeps us going, especially at this time where everyone is locked up at home and we see people, you know, going inwards. And this is the time when people realize that even more, you know, sharply, right? So thank you, Keshav, once again. As ma'am said, we'll be looking forward to, you know, having you once school reopens again and interacting in person with our children. So thanks a lot for visiting us today. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.